people, welcome to this video. Let's see how to add text and titles with Sony Movie Studio 13. Leave us comments to improve our videos. Basically, you have three main kinds of titles: the simple text, the credit rolls, and the animated text. Any text clip is placed inside a video track, showing, as frames, the text itself and a checkerboard, indicating full transparency. The way to edit and manage this clip is identical to any other clip, so we need to know how to add and edit the text inside. To add any title, you need to use a window called Media Generators. You should find it in the list of windows on the left of the preview. In case you don't find it, simply go to View, Window, and then to Media Generators. This window collects many templates ready to be used, such as titles, noises, or gradients. Credit rolls, titles and text, and legacy text are the three kinds of text templates you have. Legacy text collects inside different text templates regarding simple text not animated. Just choose one and drag it on the desired video track. When you do it, a window appears auto. This is called Video Media Generators and is used to fully edit the text inside such clip. You can open it again, right-clicking on it and going to Edit Generated Media, or on the frame icon on the text clip. In Edit section, type the text, select it and make it bold, italic, adjust its font type, size and distribution. Remember to select the text first, or you won't change anything. In Placement section, you can drag the text around to place it where you like. Don't mind about the safe zone. In Properties section, you can set advanced settings for your text. In Text Color, click on the color you like most to apply it. This will be completely a solid color. If you pull down the level on the left, you will decrease the opacity level and the text will be shown a little more transparent. You can also use the eyedropper icon to pick a particular color you see on your screen. Background color is totally transparent at first to show just the text. But if you want to add opacity, this will cover all the title clip and so all the space around the text. The size of the text background is set by the frame size above, just in case you need to adjust it. In text properties, you can use scaling, tracking to set the distance between the single letters of your text, or leading, that sets the distance between two text lines. In Effects section, you can apply some effects to your text, for example some outline to add some outer glow, add some shadow, or use deformation to deform the text. Try it out. When you are done with all, just close the window. You can animate this text to make it change in time. If you click on Animate below, a small timeline appears. It will last as much as the text clip duration in the main timeline and works through keyframes, the rhombuses you see. One is set by default and represents how the text is at first. Then move the playhead until a new instant of time, where you want the text to have a different aspect. When you change the text properties, the second keyframe will be created. if you move the playhead between the two keyframes and observe the preview, you see that the text goes changing between the two sets of properties fixed in the two different instants of time. You can delete a keyframe right-clicking on it. You will come back to the original static text in case just one keyframe is left on the small timeline. You can have other kinds of animated text, picking templates from the titles and text section. The video media generators window is a little different than before. On top you can type, set the font and the size. Click on the color rectangle to set the color. Click on the left dark arrow to add opacity and more black. Change the kind of animation through animation and scale the text using scale. Location works just like placement seen before. Advanced sets the text background, tracking and leading. Outline and shadow are the same ones seen before. The animation chosen is done and can't be changed that much. It has the same duration of the text clip, even if you change the duration of such clip. But if you trim the clip, you can change the speed of the animation to make it slower or faster. Indeed, you can personalize this kind of text as well. Next to each property, you have a watch icon. If you click on it, the small timeline will appear below, with the property interested just listed. This works exactly as seen before. By clicking on the watches, you list more properties below. You set the instant of time through the playhead then, and then change the property interested from the main window. The rows themselves will help you. The color changes in time, since it changes in the small timeline. The line goes up or down, if values change in time. The third kind of titles are the credit rolls, and are inside the credit roll section. Again, the video media generators window changes. A credit roll is composed by different items, each one with different text properties, listed all on the left. Select one of the items and go to Styles on the right to change the related properties. Each item text occupies a precise role in the credit roll. The item with the HDR icon is the header. Double-click on the right to type inside. You can see its effects directly from the main preview. The second item is the subtitle, and the others occupy the left and the right columns. You can add and edit each item text. The icon on the left sets the role. Just hold your click on. HDR is the header. The blue icon, a single column on the center. The red icon with two columns have two slots to type in, one for the left and the other one for the right column. To go on writing, following the two columns, just go on adding items with the red icons. Mind that all pieces of text that are under the same icon will share all the styles properties set on the right. Right-click on an item to delete it. In Properties, set up General Options to the Wall Credit Roll on right. Below you find the Animate button, again. This works exactly as seen with simple text before. Thanks for watching this video. Check the other videos in this guide to learn more for Sony Movie Studio 13.